I've tried to adjust it with the levels as well as color balance, and it just doesn't. Scanner is the problem because I'm running a 83-1200S scanner, which is an old scanner. That scanner cost me about $50. You can't find a mustic 50 buck scanner that is A3 size, A4 size, capable of doing work like that. I mean, it's hard to find something. What I'm looking at on the internet, about $400 minimum, well, nearly minimum. But I have seen a couple scans that look interesting, and that's who was running, and I get back to her in a minute. I was looking at a couple scanners as a possible replacement to this one in the future. It takes some time to get that 349 bill up. Is another scanner which I don't have, and this person here got a nice scan of their watercolor without all the discretion. I'm wondering also if this is the watercolor I'm using, which can be true. And I was going by the advice of Kaylee West. Seems like my watercolor is not picking up correctly. So I'm thinking that the scanner might need to go and give me a better scanner. That is a future idea, maybe a plan. next year, because I don't know if I'm going to get it this year. But that's one idea. So that's where we begin on this whole watercolor adventure. This is not making me feel confident to watercolor a particular comic book. Basically this one. I'm not too sure if I want to watercolor this now. I could easily watercolor it and just pick the color out and do this. So I still have the texture of the watercolor underneath. I wonder if that would defeat the purpose of watercoloring. It'll take more time, but I'm not too sure if this will worth the effort. If I can just color it in and just throw a texture, I've got textures to use. Yeah, that's it. So it's a decision making on. Image itself is 373 megabytes. Usually, this program, Photoshop 6, will crash if I get too close to 500 megabytes. God forbid if you get to a gig, it really tries to act up badly for days. But now I know I can scan that high. And these are the other ones I showed before. So I'm just gonna pop this up, give a quick blah blah about it. As you can see, on this watercolor, the lightest color spots just went pretty much white. Watercolor and scanning, I guess. Her body is gone. There's no way to recover that. This here, this was a different color than this. It was a little bit more. This was a darker brown. Somehow it picked up and went lighter. And this went yellow. At least the yellow that is yellow stayed yellow. The plan was for this, I was going to watercolor these, but seeing how I was running out of watercolor, it was not a good idea. So I was going to take it into Illustrator and just vector these up, which is easy. They're all geometric, not an issue. Same thing with this, kind of give a vector artwork with it. Break this up since we have more of a design. That this did not, well, I can expect it. Anytime you color anything and try to scan again, scan it in marker, color pencil, watercolor, you're going to get the artist's brush strokes and pencil scratches in there. You're going to see the ugly surface, you're going to see the texture, you're going to see the pattern. This is not unfixable, really. I mean, you're an artist. You take the time and turn this mistake or failure here into a golden egg. That's what you do. So, with that one, I'm just going to shut this down. And own site and go to my own selection of artists and show you where I was going with this. Here you go. This is an artist that kind of inspired the idea of watercoloring a comic book. Look how that is. That is beautiful. Somehow get stuck into the teeth of the watercolor paper. Kind of sucks and is great. You know you're gonna have lines, but sucks and is great. Apparently he inked right on top of the watercolor because he might have inked and didn't watercolor. I mean, if he did, this did not leak. That does not look like leakage. I'm not too sure if that was. Watercolor patching is works great for the ocean and the sky. That's beautiful. But this is what inspired me to do a comic in watercolor. But the fact that I failed to scan in a decent piece of artwork, yeah, it's making me go, this person here knows a little bit more than what he is showing you. And if you like this artist, hop up in here, get into Bastic, discovering the world. And there's some other artists in here that did watercolor as well. Like this here. Now this works. I don't know where I'm feeling. This works. Let's see some other artwork. Look at that. That is nice. That's right where they had the tea bag. But yeah, forgiveness. This here is nice. Too far into the background, but then again, more attention is supposed to be on you against us here. But yeah, now if I could get to that level, see what I'm saying? Look at that. The watercolor is cool, solid, not blasted out. That's what I'm trying to get to. Some of these artists have stopped. I don't know why. This one only put one page up. I wish he or she continued on with more. This kind of leaves with a cliffhanger. Not even a cliffhanger, it's just... This is still better than what I have done. I mean, really. I don't know if it's the watercolor or my scanner. But this is, to me, working. You got a hand, face, person standing here. I mean, this does not look blown out. It looks like you can tell where everything is. It doesn't look like they're going to use a color. Maybe use a color pencil for this line here. But this is good. Just for the sheer coloring and stuff. The texture's seeable. Texture's seeable and everything. is where I want to get to for my watercolors. Showing up strong enough where it's not looking blown out. Even though I'm not too sure if it's just because of the yellow, which might be a result to the yellow. Might have blown out. Blue green was a bit blown out too. Well, I gotta do some more research on this. Well, if not, I've got a plan for that failure too. I can always go back and fill in the color. It'd be much easier than what I did with the artwork yesterday. So I'm gonna start with that. Go and come back and start messing with some watercolor. Alright. Check it out for now.